largest Latino.
Yes, it's charged.
Large and it's charged.
What age did you leave that house?
When I left Barbados, which was 16. When I put out my first single, I was still living there.
Wow.
I come back here all the time.
What does it feel like?
I just get all these memories. I get a lot of memories. I still feel like I belong here, you know? Like all my friends, are like the people that grew up with me through here. They all still live out here. So when I come, I see a lot of familiar faces.
Were you nervous to leave from here?
No. This was everything for me, but I knew what I wanted in life. Tainted, so I stay thirsty for more. No, I won't hold back. No drop is wasted.
I'm from West Brighton Road, Barbados. We grew up together. I remember we used to spend a lot of Sundays, me and the other boys, shouting across to her house while she was grabbing a shower, trying to tell her to shut up and stop singing so we could hear football. It took us a little while to get used to calling her Rihanna rather than calling her Robin, as everybody in the neighborhood would know her. But she used to sing all the time, because we never really used to take it seriously. But I guess that's what she always wanted to do. But for us, it's a little different, right? For us, being closer to her than some of the other people on the island and so on, growing up with her, you know, she couldn't do anything wrong. We were supporting whatever she did. We knew at the end of the day that, you know, being a pop star, it's a big difference between being a pop star and being a pastor in a church. So it's not that everything she does that everybody likes or agrees with, but we always support her. At the end of the day, she's a woman. She makes her own decisions. So at the end of the day, you know, we're here for her. As you know, as generations come and go, some of the older folks that she would have grown up around, some of them have passed. There have been a couple people who've moved in the neighborhood. I myself, I'm pretty much in and out as well, so a lot has changed. If it's an award show, if it's someplace she turns up for dinner, if it's an appearance, she always remembers where she came from. She still remains humble, and that's something that we can all appreciate. We're not fussy people, so to speak. We just relax, we just kick back. So it's good to see that she can take that from her home and show the world what we're about. To me, she's still Robin, still big head. Robin, keep it up. Everybody behind you 100%. You know, you can do very little wrong for us. And if you're wrong, we'll tell you you're wrong. And if you're right, we'll support you 100%.
You all right, Jen?
Yeah, what's
the best? Okay, now step on.
Float her in.
That's
easily the most fun we have. Okay,
float her in.
Yeah. Oh, wait, my top is on there. Same thing, just a different brand. And that shit we got home off is derelict. It's so much fun. We're gonna do it again tomorrow.
I got one left.
My
bathing suit,
I took it on
my couch.
Yeah.
I do that every day.
So much fun. Oh.
thanks. Yeah.
All right, thank you.
You're
thank
welcome.
You. All right, I'll be right back, guys. Okay. Gotta grab it.
Gangsta boo. That's my name on the tag with Armani's name. Big things are going, buddy.
Alright. Look at that. I have my own charm now. My own Armani charm.
I'm excited.
Top that target. In stores Monday.
Oh, this is the actual.
That's yours.
That was an ill detail. You see the top that top between the two.
This is so good. So in the deluxe they have a copy of the standard cover, a copy of the deluxe cover, just to collect and keep. And they could actually just use any of these in the standard cover actually. It fits the same size.
Every picture just reminded me of the whole process.
Oh good.
And it really was last week. Like, that's what really freaking me out. That was last week, and I hear holding it, like, I could put this on and hear what I recorded a week ago.
What was it like recording the album? Like, outside of studios?
That was the best ever. It was some rock star shit. I'm not gonna let you, that's the craziest schedule I've ever been on in my entire life. So much soul. One morning, I just woke up and I started. So hard. Finally got to my bed from the venue, from the IV and everything. And I was just like, good. Like, I can actually get to sleep tonight. Because we stayed up, I finished it at like 5 p.m. the year before. Now, I'm like, one good night of rest. Get in bed. It could not have been 2 hours in. Before my phone started going off, like blowing up. I was so frustrated that I kept like ignoring the phone every time it would go off. But every time I would ignore it, it would be like another burden put on my shoulders because I know it has to get done. But I know I'm sick and I know like I'm the only person that can get it done. So it was so frustrating, so I was angry. I was so overwhelmed, I was sick, like it felt crazy. Then I woke up and I'm trying to call everybody. I can't get through to anybody.
because now in America, it's time to sleep and everybody's asleep. Now I'm up, ready to work, ready to answer questions. I was so upset. I cried. I cried for like 10 minutes really, really hard in my pillow. And then I was done. I got up and I showered and I started to work. And I called my room and we sat and wrote out our thank yous. Sat and went through a list of that had to be done.
How was the cry?
It was aggressive. Like, because I don't cry loud. I don't even cry. But if I cry, it's because I'm really angry and I can't do anything about it. Because I ran into a dead end. Like, nothing you can do about the situation. That's when the tears would come down. But this time, like, I needed to hear it. I almost wanted to punch somebody. Like, I was like, you f***ing serious? But then I thought, they don't have a choice. I'm the only person they could get the answers from, and there's nothing I could do about it. Like, I need to do this. Then I could go to sleep. I tell myself I do this now. But I was so overwhelmed. I just had it. And the emails that was coming in were just so inconsiderate. Boom. Everything that was going on with me was completely disregarded. It was just like to the point where like everything that just happened prior, like she just got unplugged from her. The IV was literally like she was still bleeding from the IV.
Shut up.
Yes. Like no, I still had it, and it was like all was just swipes. But it didn't matter. What I'm saying is, when I got the two copies in my hands in it, I mean I got the standard a couple of days ago, but when I got the deluxe, it was so worth it. It was so. I would never take it back. I mean, I really at times wished things could have been different and like easier, but then I wouldn't really care when I got the album. You know, if I took 10 years to make this, and it wouldn't be that special. The fact that I just recorded this last week and I have it in my hand today is pretty fantastic. And to see it. And to know that, I feel like my fans were there, sitting at the edge of their seats every step of the way with me. Like every time I would tweet something about it, they felt like they were right there at that very moment. So I can't wait for them to see their album, really. My story, but it's really their
shit.
To celebrate. It's a sold out show here in Manchester tonight. We have a number one song in the UK with We Found Love. And as of today, Talk That Talk is number one on iTunes in the UK. So Manchester, this is to you. Cheers!
Album, how does it feel?
Sweaty and hot. I mean, honestly, it's a miracle. Really, like this was just a dream. That's why it's a miracle. It's awesome, man. I mean, I feel closer to my fans now than I've ever, ever, ever felt. And I mean, I should because it's 6 albums, so. 6 moments of my life, but every time I give them a little more. And now I feel like I'm staring them right in their eyes because we pretty much made this album together, so it's an incredible feeling. Because of the circumstances and how difficult it was to make this album and how much work we put into it, it feels that much better, like 1,000 times better to have the final product and to not only share it with the world, but to see people react the way they are, is like, I could not customize that myself any better. That's all I got, Evan.